welcome all. Make our presentation for today is make an easy switch to Lightning by handling your complex JavaScript buttons. Here is a familiar forward-looking statement. Customers should make your purchasing decisions based on the features that are currently available. And your presenters for today. My name is Ramya Ramamurthy. I work as a managing director and technical architect of Salesforce Development at Teach for America. And here's my awesome colleague, Shanti Angareddy, who is also a technical architect. So agenda for today. So why are we here? So what are the use cases we were using JavaScript buttons for in Classic? What are some of the lightweight alternatives that are currently available in Lightning? We are going to take a deep dive into the complex use cases that we have, how we solved it in our organization, and you're sure to walk away with code samples that are going to work both in Classic and Lightning. JavaScript, we all loved it, right? Like, I loved it. It's a robust language. It has so many features. It has access to DOM, BOM, great. However, if it falls under some malicious actors, it can be disastrous. It can change your HTML, XML elements. It can introduce cross-site scripting errors or trap your user sessions. Hence, we all know JavaScript buttons are no longer supported in Lightning. And fortunately, we have a locker service which you can use to secure your Lightning components. And of course, Lightning is the future, and that's why we are here. We are having so many out-of-box declarative options that you could see that I'll be discussing throughout this session. So why did we all love JavaScript buttons? That's the reason why we are here, right? We used it in Classic to redirect to anything, right? We redirected to a record page. We redirected to a third-party website, to a Visual Force page with passing those parameters, or even send your emails with template IDs. Fortunately, if you have like kind of only this kind of simple use cases, what you could do is you can replace it directly with your URL buttons that are going to work in Lightning. Continuing on, we were able to use feedback screens that you are waiting for user input or a confirmation screen. So we loved it. And we were doing mass actions in list views. We were able to mass update, mass transfer your owners using your JavaScript buttons. So the alternatives which we found was, like you could use flows, particularly if you have not started using it, I would highly recommend you start doing it for your user screens. It's an intuitive admin-friendly tool, as well as your Visual Force page buttons is going to work in list views in Lightning. So you could do that as your replacement. And pre-populating values, this is my favorite use case. I love doing those URL hacks, passing my field IDs. Oh, it's no longer supported. And we love defaulting our record types with it. Fortunately, I have quick actions for it. So quick actions are like available at your global and object-specific levels. So global, I mean, like you can have actions across your app or your specific actions only for that particular object. For those of you like who are not so familiar with quick actions, what you could do is you can go to your object, click on new action, and it'll give you a variety of options like this for you to, like, let's say you want to create a record, quickly update a record, invoke your Visual Force or your Lightning component, you could do it. And once you save it, it kind of gives you, depends on your target object, you can also default your record types like this. And then it also gives you a cool edit layout option. So once you click it, you're going to get a nice layout editor like this, where you can quickly drag and drop all your fields for that object, which is kind of very cool. And you can also predefine your values. So you click on the new button, all the values, all those fields are available there, and then you can just default those values. So if you're having cases where you're like predefining, you could really use this quick actions. However, okay, no, we are not limited by it. We are having many more complex use cases. So quick actions has certain limitations that you cannot directly use for certain complex cases. What do we do for that? So why am I saying there are some limitations? Not all kind of lookup fields are there for you to predefine, right? So I can have account, I can have a quick create opportunity. I can have access to my opportunity fields and account fields, but what if I want to have a lookup to all my other objects, right? So you don't have that. And secondly, you have to like drag and drop is great. If you want like quickly create, quickly update, yeah, it's okay. But you still don't have actions where you can like copy your object specific page layouts directly onto your layout editor. So that's kind of limiting us. And then let's say you have object specific page layouts, and then you have quick actions and you have action layouts also, which means the moment you want to add more and more fields to your object, then you have to take care that you added both your object layout as well as your action layouts. So from maintenance perspectives, it is kind of takes more effort. And if you have complex use cases, so it is kind of limited. So if you have quick ones, yes, you can do it. But we are talking about more complex use cases, right? So we did run into our all this in our organization as well. So what we did, we used lightning actions for it. So lightning actions are nothing but quick actions that are going to invoke your lightning components. So because it is lightning components, it has inherent access to all your fields, including your lookup fields across your objects. And it has dynamic sensing capability. Your metadata is dynamically detected there. Which means I don't have to kind of like worry about scenarios where I have to add fields in object specific action layouts and so on. So thus it's going to give us more greater flexibility. So let's look at those use cases where we were able to solve it using this lightning actions, and that's going to work in lightning alone, right? So the first use case that you're going to see today is defaulting your lookup values. So what am I doing? So let's say I'm creating a new task and I'm creating a new event. What I need to do is I have to default my assigned ID or assigned to who ID, what ID, subject, etc. And I also have business rules for it. Let's say I'm a campus recruiter in a campus and I'm interviewing a prospect and I'm going to capture my meeting notes. Then my business wants me to assign my who IDs automatically as the local or the regional recruitment contact. And they wanted me to extend the same functionality depending on the user. Let's say I'm from the finance team and I wanted to default all my, when I'm talking to the donor, my who ID has to be automatically assigned with the regional donor contact. So I have business rules for it. So what can I do with it? I thought, let me do a quick action for everything, right? But when I went and saw that, I don't have my who ID. So this was a limitation I was talking about, like certain lookup fields are not available. So what did I do? I ended up creating a lightning component and I made use of all the lightning data service features. So if you're not still familiar with lightning data service, you know like how we could like kind of quickly create, load, record without having to write your Apex code and hit handles the field level security for you. So let's see, what did I do? So I created my first lightning component like this, and then I'm implementing force has record ID. So what does it do? This is the magic word which this record, when I'm defining my record data, record ID equal to v.record ID, it's going to store the ID of the record in which I'm going to invoke this lightning component. And I also have a target fields attribute. So this v.account, let's say I'm in the account and like I'm creating new tasks. So v.account is going to have access to all the fields of the account. So I'm not restricted to any fields here. And then I have a button. Wherein, like I'm going to, when I invoke that button, it's going to give me, or it's going to see c.create new task, which is the client-side controller. Now, going ahead with the controller, what I do in the controller, so my component is created, now I have the client-side controller. So as I said, v.account is going to help me pass through all the account fields. So I get my contact ID, regional contact, donor contact, recruitment, whatever, I'm not restricted here, so I can get all those fields. And then now I'm free to assign my who IDs and what IDs and assign to. I have all the fields in my layout right now. Then I go ahead and what do? So now I have to fire off the task with all these values pre-populated. So I make use of this force create record event, and then I pass on this entity name here as task. So you can be task, event, whatever your object name, right? And then I'm defaulting all my field values so that the moment people click on that button, it's going to nicely create this task with all these values pre-populated. And that's it. I fired my create record event. So if you do have complex logic, right? I don't want just that account fields alone. I do want something else. I want to pass this account ID and get some background information also that you want to automatically capture in your comments. Then you are not restricted with client-side controllers. You could still invoke your server-side controllers, your Apex classes. What you need to do to be invoked is make sure they are all ARRA enabled, right? Like you have this annotation for those methods and you should be able to get that. That's it. With this simple thing, we are able to solve the complex logic. So how do you add this lightning component then? Simple, create an action, invoke this lightning component and add it to your page layout. Or You can also do this. You can directly go to that particular page layout, click on edit page, that's going to open up the app builder like this, and your left-hand side will have all your Lightning components, and then you can just drag and drop it to it. Very simple and effective for this use case, right? What about complex use case? Like, we'll take a further deep dive. Oh, I'm not restricted in that alone. Let's say I have a parent object as research profile. What we do here, we are actually capturing all our donor information, their background, or their motivations, and so on, everything about the donor. And let's say when they are ready to donate, I wanted to create an opportunity out of it with all the values pre-populated from a parent object. Not only that, I have to make sure that I go ahead and update the status back in my research profile that now they are now ready to donate. So what do I do there? In Classic, I had my JavaScript calling a Visual Force page, and inside the Visual Force page, I was going into my Apex controller, and then I did the URL hack. I was like populating all my field IDs directly and then invoking my opportunity. We know URL hacks are not going to work in Lightning, so what do? We went for Lightning actions for it. So this is a similar thing that we saw earlier, that we have created a record data, we have created the record ID, my target fields. One thing that is different here is fields. Why am I saying this? You can also use this fields attribute to get only specific fields from your parent record. Either you can use your target fields to get the entire thing, or for much more efficiency, you can also use this fields attribute. And the other thing you would note here, I have specifically said mode equal to edit. Why am I doing this? Because I have to go back and update my status in my parent record. So the default is mode equal to view. So the next thing is, you also note that I have a record update attribute here. What does this do? This will keep on detecting the changes to your record, and then I have the ability then to see, oh, okay, my parent record is changed. Now, what am I going to do with it? Should I reload the record, or should I redirect the user? So I have the control over it. So this record updated will then, when it detects it, it will invoke the c.onRecordUpdater, which is nothing but your client-side controller. And that's it. And then you have, when you click on this button, opportunity, let's see what happens. So let's say, the create opportunity controller, the component is ready now. So let's see the logic behind the method. So here in the create opportunity, now my the entity API name, I use the same force create record so that I can nicely open the opportunity record with all my parameters filled out. So here the entity is opportunity, and I'm defaulting all the field values with my research profile records values. So, and then I fire off this record event. And then I have one more duty to do. I have to go back and update my parent status, right? So what I do is I'm finding this, detecting this record data, and use the LDS feature .saveRecord that I can directly save that records that now they are ready to donate also. Once I'm done with it, remember, like we had this record updated attribute that is constantly listening to the changes that I have updated the parent record. So this is going to invoke this on record updated client side controller, and see it is saying like, oh, now it has changed, so now we need to reload the record with the fresh values. And you can also have like toast messages, like user-friendly messages. Oh, now that it has been changed, we have been successful, or any error messages. So you can use your force show toast and pass your parameters and fire off your toast event like this. So with a simple component, and you please note that we have not written Apex code at all so far. So with just this Lightning Data Service features, we were able to achieve this complex use case. So far, you saw all the use cases where it is working in Lightning specific actions. So you might be thinking, what about certain things that I wanted now itself? I don't want to worry about it in my Lightning roadmap. Tell me something that's going to work directly now in Classic and Lightning. Okay, here we are. So Shanti is going to walk us through that.
Thanks, Ramya. So without further ado, I'll directly get into the use case because we are short on time. So how many of you here have hacked clone URL? Perfect. And it doesn't work in Lightning, is it? Right. So we have a use case where we use opportunities to track donor information. And our finance team creates lots of opportunities that reoccur at the beginning of every fiscal year, right? So this, furthermore, they want to clone all the opportunities so that all the information gets copied over with the blanking out very specific financial information. And we want to prevent any issues that arise with the manual data entry, right? And we also have a lot of page layouts and record types. And we should have a mechanism where it dynamically detects underlying metadata to identify and then copy over the values. Moreover, we use this functionality at 7 different objects. So it comes to us, it's onus on us that we have to provide this solution to our business so that they can continue to perform both in Classic and Lightning. So it would be nice to have a solution where we can dynamically detect the changes of the underlying metadata. Second, it should be easy to drag and drop. Because it's duplicated, we should be able to use the same functionality all over. And finally, have a one set of a place where we can store all this information so that we can default the values. Most importantly, it should work both in Classic and Lightning, right? So let's see how we accomplish this. So I'm not going to go into the implementation details. We have implemented this for you. So please go ahead and download the package from this GitHub. Once you download it, all you have to do is create a custom clone button with the information. So all you have to do is pass in the object ID. So in our case, we are using the payment ID, or you can use any custom object or standard object to clone wherever you need to. Once that is done, other place is we have created a custom, we have used the custom metadata types to store all the values where we want to default certain values, either blanking out or pre-populating values. As you can see, there's an object, there's a field, and there's a value. So you set it up, it works, that's it. So three simple steps. One, you create a clone button. Second, you just add it to the page layout, both in Lightning and Classic. And then you just create the fields that you want to default in the custom metadata types. So simple, right? You should definitely go and do it yourself in your org. We saved you a ton of time. So what are the next steps? So this is the time that if you are in the middle of doing transitioning, so you should definitely perform readiness report analysis. First, you should categorize all the JavaScript buttons that are in your org that you want to find the solutions for. So once you categorize them in a way that, you know, all URL hacks will come together, you know, all the pre-population will come together, and then start providing the solutions. Always remember, tackle the easiest one first. That gives you so much of confidence. Moving on. And please don't forget to check these resources out. There is a Lightning Experience Configuration Converter that will detect all the JavaScripts in your org. And the Salesforce also provides a Lex components, which is a GitHub, which is a list of all the Lightning components, which you can directly use it in your system, so which is amazing. So to wrap up, to reiterate, right? So first, you categorize your buttons. And second, as Ramya shared earlier, evaluate if we can use the Lightning lightweight alternatives like URL buttons or quick actions or canvas actions or flows. Okay, if that doesn't work, move on to the Lightning actions and the Lightning data solutions. If that doesn't, they also provided a new attribute called Lightning is URS addressable, which is a way to navigate from one Lightning component to another component, and you can pass in the parameters. Finally, we provide the solution for the dynamic visual force page buttons, and definitely go check it out. So there are so many sessions and experts here that you can reach out. But if you have a very specific use case that you couldn't find the solution, please feel free to Twitter us, and we would love to find solution for you. And we are active in Lightning Now community, so you can reach out us there as well. So a gentle reminder that there's a developer keynote tomorrow at 1. So please attend that, and it requires a registration. So please do attend that. Thank you. If you have any questions, we would be here for some time. And please don't forget to take the survey at the end of the session so we can bring better content to you next year. Thank you.